Hi everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Simran and I make beauty content here on YouTube. So if that interests you, I hope you consider subscribing to my channel if you haven't already. In today's video, I'm going to review the Maybelline Matte Plus Poreless Fit Me Foundation. It's going to be an in-depth review and I will try to give as many details as possible. I'm going to talk about the price of the foundation, the shade range, how it performs. Another thing would be I have been using this foundation for years now. This is not the first time that I'm using it. And you know, this is not my first impressions of the foundation. So this video was requested by one of you guys on Instagram. I really never would have thought of making a review on such a popular foundation because so many reviews are already on the internet about this foundation. So with all of that out of the way, let's get into the video. Let's start with the packaging. So this foundation comes in a glass bottle. It comes in two variants. One has a pump, which is the one that I have, and the other one is the one that's without the pump. I used to have that one. The without pump version of this foundation is worth 500 rupees, and this version, which is the version that has the pump, it is worth 549 rupees, so essentially 50 rupees more for the pump. Maybelline also recently came out with a tube version of this foundation. It's supposed to be very travel friendly because it's in a plastic squeezy tube, so it won't break, and it's also very little and lightweight. I have not personally used it. Now, I would recommend this squeezy tube foundation for people who have not tried out the Maybelline Fit Me foundation and would like to try it out first before buying the full-sized version. This squeezy tube version has 8 ml of product in it and it's priced at rupees 299. It also has SPF 22 in it, which the foundations in the glass bottle, they don't have it. I don't really like SPF in my foundation if it gives me flashback. The squeezy tube version is only available in 6 shades, at least on Nykaa. However, there are 18 shades available in the glass bottle version of this foundation. If you would like to find out your Maybelline shade, Maybelline has a virtual try on. I will link it in the description down below, where you can literally just use a phone camera or your laptop camera, I think even, and you can use that to find your Maybelline shade. But I still think the best way would be to try it out in a store. I know that could be a little bit hard given the situation that we all are living in, but if you can try out the shades in person, then I would definitely recommend doing that. My shade in this foundation is 230 Natural Buff. So let me read all the claims that the Maybelline Fit Me foundation makes. So first of all, it says that it's for normal to oily skin. Yes, of course, it is definitely more suited for normal to oily skin, and I have combination skin that's more on the oily end. However, I have also seen people with dry skin types love this foundation. You just have to know how to correctly prep your base, but of course I can't personally comment on it since I do not have dry skin. Mattifies and refines pores. I agree that it mattifies. It makes a very slight difference on the appearance of my pores. I don't know about that claim, but it definitely mattifies. Matches natural tone. For sure, it definitely matches the natural tone for me. Natural seamless finish. Now, this is something that I actually love about this foundation. There are so many matte foundations out there that actually make your skin look dry and cakey and gross, even if you have oily skin type or combination skin type like I do. This does not do that at all. The kind of matte finish that this foundation gives does not make your face look completely flat and completely like super matte. It's definitely, as they say it is, it's a more natural matte kind of a finish, which I absolutely love, and which is exactly why I think it works even for dry skin types. Let's get into the more interesting part. I'm going to put this foundation onto my face in front of you guys right now and you'll see how well it covers. I'm going to do half of my face with a brush and then half of my face with a damp sponge. So this is going to be my brush side. You will actually see that this foundation feels extremely lightweight on your skin. I'm using this e.l.f. Buffing Foundation Brush to blend the foundation out on this side. By the way, I've already prepped my skin and I have concealer underneath my eyes because this is something that I always do no matter what foundation I'm using. Did you see how flawlessly and how fast it blended? I'm also going to see if this foundation oxidizes or not. after I'm done applying this side. So this side is the side without foundation, and this is the side with foundation. As you can see, this side is way more matte than this side because I do have strobe cream underneath this. However, you can see that there is still some amount of glow to my skin, and I love that. I'm going to apply foundation on this side after 5 minutes because I want to see if this side has oxidized or not. So it's been about 5 minutes, and I'm going to take a new pump of this foundation and apply it on this side to see if it has oxidized. I think it has slightly oxidized. As you can see, this freshly applied foundation looks lighter than this side. Now, usually with a sponge, you don't get as much of a coverage as you would with a brush, of course, because the sponge soaks up a lot more product than a brush. But in general, this foundation has a medium to buildable coverage, which means that when you start out with this foundation, you get a medium coverage, as I have gotten. But if you wanted to build it to a full coverage, you can also achieve that with this foundation. I've been using this foundation for years, and I still can't get over how smooth and airbrushed and flawless it makes my skin look, and also how easy it is to blend into my skin. Okay, so this side I did with the damp beauty sponge, and this side I did with a brush. Which side do you like better? Comment down below. I think the side that I did with the brush looks more matte versus this side. It's very glowy. That is to be expected when you use a damp sponge. Definitely adds a glow to your base. Honestly, coverage wise, I feel like both sides look equally good. I used the same amount of product on both sides, and both sides look pretty much the same. With sponges, you most of the times lose coverage, but I guess not with this. Okay, so I'm going to complete my makeup and be right back. I'm going to give you my final thoughts and my final review and a summary of the entire video. Now let's talk about the foundation. So first of all, I feel like the price is of course subjective, right? Like with everything, 500 rupees or even 550 rupees, I feel like is a good price for a drugstore foundation. And if I'm being honest, Maybelline is literally always on discount. So there is literally no need for you to pay even those 500 rupees. Price wise, I feel like it's amazing. The shade range I do not like. It's only 18 shades for the glass bottle, and for the tubes, it's only 6 shades. So that's not inclusive at all. I really do wish that in the future they come out with even more shades and have like 30-40 shades at least. Let's talk about the performance of the foundation. Okay, so at this point I've had the foundation on for 2 to 3 hours, and it still looks pretty good and matte. I'm not oily whatsoever. I did set it with the Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder. I love the finish of the foundation. It's not a complete flat matte finish. It's a very natural matte finish. As you can see, even after 2 hours, it has not gotten oily whatsoever on my skin, and I do have combination skin type. Coverage on this foundation is another amazing thing. Like I said, it's medium to buildable coverage, so you can get a desired coverage with this foundation. So I would recommend this foundation for normal to oily skin types, which also includes combination skin. For drier skin types, I think you should get, if you can, a sample of this, or maybe a small sized version of this. Maybe if your friend or a relative has it, borrow like one time use worth of foundation and see how it looks on you. Oh, and keep in mind that this foundation oxidizes, as we saw. So there are two cons of this foundation in my opinion. One is the shade range is crap. Second is that it oxidizes. Now everything else is a pro. I love the finish. I love how long it lasts. I love the coverage of the foundation. I love the price of the foundation. I love the packaging of the foundation. So is this foundation Simran approved? Yes, it is Simran approved. That is why I've been using it for years and years and years, and I will probably always continue using this. So if you've always wanted to get this foundation, let this video be your sign. Go and get a Maybelline foundation. And yes, with that we come to an end to today's video. But before you go, please let me know what other product do you want me to review next. It could be a skincare item, a makeup item, or any beauty item, accessory, tool, brand, anything. Just let me know in the comments down below or on DMs in my Instagram. I always answer all my DMs. Don't forget to follow me on my socials, which are Instagram and Twitter. I will link those along with this foundation in my description box. So please go and check out my description box. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like this video and subscribe for more beauty content. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.